Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Benjamin and you are watching Sartorial Styles. Today I will show you some of my favorite tie knots and pocket square folds, how to combine them and what to keep in mind when using these accessories. Let's go! This video is brought to you by Oliver Wicks. They did not pay me, but they generously sent me a couple of ties and pocket squares from their collection to show you different knots and folding techniques. If you want to learn more about them, click on the info card up there in the corner to watch my review. Let's start with a very simple tie knot. It is called the 4-in-hand and it actually is one of my favorites, especially for thicker ties like this light blue grenadine silk tie. It has an asymmetrical but very elegant shape and it easily produces a nice dimple. With this tie, the dimple appears on its own. If it doesn't when you try it with one of your ties, just pinch the fabric together before you pull it through the loop. This actually works with pretty much every knot, by the way. With a non-pattern tie like this, I love to throw in a more busy pocket square. This blue one would be a little too close color-wise and quite matchy-matchy for my taste. But this rust, yellow and blue one works perfectly fine with the combination I am wearing at the moment. Because tweed is a more casual fabric, I love to go for the reverse hand puller fold. Yes, I made this name up, but here you can see what I mean. Something very important to keep in mind when choosing your tie knot is the collar shape of your shirt. This flannel shirt is from Oliver Wicks and it has a pretty classic collar shape. This shirt, on the other hand, features a wide spread collar. A 4-in-hand knot will not look best with this collar shape. The knot is too small and the part of the tie hanging around your neck will peek underneath the collar. That's not a nice look. A wider knot is the better choice for a widespread collar. So let's put on my grey 3-piece suit and go for a double 4-in-hand. This knot is very similar to the 4-in-hand, but a bit wider and more suitable for thin ties and widespread collars. Stripes on stripes can work, and I think this silk tie works very well with the pink shirt I am wearing. Let's put on another suit, this time not in a solid color. Here you can see my double-breasted suit with irregular stripes, still one of my favorites for formal occasions. With a suit like this, I like to wear smooth silk ties. A grenadine tie or another textured fabric can work as well, but it can also clash with the pattern of the suit. The tie and the suit should not have to fight for attention. This more muted and smooth silk tie in a rust color with a blue pattern should work very well. Keeping the theme of using more muted accessories, let's go for a plain white silk pocket square in a presidential fold. A great look, isn't it? For the last look, I decided to wear a double 4-in-hand knot once again. Especially with such a bold and powerful suit, an even wider knot can work as well. The half Windsor is a bit more complicated to tie, but a great classic look. I personally don't wear it too much, but if you like it, go for it. Let's create another outfit, this time a more casual one. I am wearing a sports jacket with a plaid pattern and light grey flannels. This grey and blue tie from Oliver Wicks works very well with this look. I went for a 4-in-hand knot because the shirt has a classic collar. This yellow pocket square is a bold but good choice, this time with the regular hand puller fold. And that's it, some pocket square and tie combinations featuring accessories by Oliver Wicks. If you like their ties and pocket squares, click on the link down below in the description to explore their collection. Their suits are very nice as well, two of my videos about them are linked up there. Down there, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel. Have a nice time and see you next week.